The Lord be with you. Let us pray. Loving God, we are saints gathered to worship and praise you this morning. We celebrate the saints who have served you and who have been an example for us to follow. We give you thanks for the joy of being a part of the communion of saints with those who have gone before and those scattered around the globe. As we come to worship you this morning, let us put aside thoughts that are not of you. Let's forget about ourselves, concentrate on you, and just worship you now. We place you at the highest place now, Lord God, as we recognize your presence in our midst this morning. Help us to continue, Lord, by being the saints you have called us to be. In Christ's name, and for his sake we pray. Amen. Our opening hymn this morning from our CPWI number 819, For All the Saints.
Thank you.
Good morning, brothers and sisters. Our service continues on page 32 of our Book of Common Prayer. Let old earth acclaim God, sing to the glory of his name, make his praise glorious. The Lord is in his holy temple. Let all the earth keep silence before him. We give thanks to the Father who has made us worthy to share in the inheritance of the saints in light. Versicle 2. Hear us, O God. We will exalt you, O God, our Savior. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. Together, we pray the prayer at the top of page 36 in our prayer book. Father, we come together in the name of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Redeemer, to offer you our worship, praise, and thanksgiving. To you belong all power and glory. You are the source of all goodness. Let our worship bear witness to your peace and saving power. Through your Spirit, may we ever rejoice in the abiding presence of our risen and ascended Lord. Amen. Divinity. Together. O come, let us sing out to the Lord. Let us shout in triumph to the rock of our salvation. Let us come before his face with thanksgiving and cry out to him joyfully in the Psalms. For the Lord is a great God, and a great King above all gods. In his hands are the depths of the earth, and the peaks of the mountains are his also. The sea is his, and he made it. His hands molded dry land. Come, let us worship and bow down, and kneel before the Lord our Maker, for he himself is our God. We are the people of his pasture and the sheep of his hand. If only you would hear his voice today, for he comes to judge the earth. He shall judge the world with righteousness and the people with his truth. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. As it was in the beginning, is now, and shall be forever. Amen. Lord, we pray to you for the forgiveness of our sins. Together, have mercy upon us, most merciful Father. In your compassion, forgive us our sins, known and unknown, things done and left undone. And so uphold us by your Spirit, that we may live and serve you in newness of life, to the honor and glory of your name, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Set us free from the bondage of our sins, and give us the liberty of that abundant life which you have made known to us in your Son, O Savior Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen.
The psalm appointed for this morning is Psalm 34, reading from verse 1 to 10. And verse 22. I will bless the Lord at all times. His praise shall ever be in my mouth. I will glory in the Lord. Let the humble hear and rejoice. Proclaim with me the greatness of the Lord. Let us exalt his name together. I sought the Lord, and he answered me, and delivered me out of all my terror. Look upon him and be radiant, and let not your faces be ashamed. I called in my affliction, and the Lord heard me, and saved me from all my troubles. The angel of the Lord encompasses those who fear him, and he will deliver them. Taste and see that the Lord is good. Happy are they who trust in him. Fear the Lord, you that are his saints. For those who fear him lack nothing. The young lions lack and suffer hunger, but those who seek the Lord lack nothing that is good. The Lord ransoms the life of his servants, and none will be punished who trust in him. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and shall be forever. Amen.
The Revelation of Jesus Christ to St. John, written in the 7th chapter, from verse 9 through to 17. After this I beheld, and lo, a great multitude, which no man could number, of all nations and kindreds and people and tongues, stood before the throne and before the Lamb, clothed with white robes and palms in their hands, and cried with a loud voice, saying, Salvation to our God, which sitteth upon the throne, and unto the Lamb. And all the angels stood round about the throne, and about the elders and the four beasts, and fell before the throne on their faces, and worshipped God, saying, Amen. Blessing and glory and wisdom and thanksgiving and honor and power and might be unto our God forever and ever. Amen. And one of the elders answered, saying unto me, What are these which are arrayed in white robes? And whence came they? And I said unto him, Sir, thou knowest. And he said to me, These are they which came out of great tribulation, and have washed their robes, and made them white in the blood of the Lamb. Therefore are they before the throne of God, and serve him day and night in his temple. And he that sitteth on the throne shall dwell among them. They shall hunger no more, neither thirst any more, neither shall the sun light on them, nor any heat. For the Lamb which is in the midst of the throne shall feed them, and shall lead them unto living fountains of water, and God shall wipe away all tears from their eyes. This is the word of the Lord.
We will say the Benedictus together. Blessed are you, Lord, the God of Israel. You have come to your people and set them free. You've raised up for us the mighty Savior, born of the house of your servant David. Through your holy prophets, you promised of old to save us from our enemies, from the hands of all that hate us, to show mercy to our forebears, and to remember your holy covenant. This was the oath you swore to our father Abraham, to set us free from the hands of our enemies, free to worship you without fear, holy and righteous before you all the days of our life. And you, child, shall be called the prophet of the Most High, for you will go before the Lord to prepare the way, to give God's people knowledge of salvation by the forgiveness of their sins. In the tender compassion of our God, the dawn from on high shall break upon us, to shine upon those who dwell in darkness and the shadow of death, and to guide our feet into the way of peace. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and shall be forever. Amen.
A reading from the Word of God, as written in 1 John 3, reading from verses 1 to 3. See what great love the Father has lavished on us, that we should be called the children of God. And that is what we are. The reason the world does not know us is that it did not know him. Dear friends, now we are children of God, and what we will be has not yet been made known. But we know that when Christ appears, we shall be like him, for we shall see him as he is. All who have this hope in him purify themselves, just as he is pure. The word of the Lord.
Our hymn for the gradual from our CPWI 266, 266, Breathe on Me, Breath of God.
Fill me with love.
The Lord be with you. The Holy Gospel according to Matthew. When Jesus saw the crowds, he went up the mountain, and after he sat down, his disciples came to him. Then he began to speak and taught them, saying, "Blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are those who mourn, for they will be comforted. Blessed are the meek, for they will inherit the earth. Blessed are those who hunger and thirst for righteousness, for they will be filled. Blessed are the merciful, for they will receive mercy. Blessed are the pure in heart, for they will see God. Blessed are the peacemakers, for they will be called children of God. Blessed are those who are persecuted for righteousness' sake, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are you when people revile you and persecute you and utter all kinds of evil against you falsely on my account. Rejoice and be glad, for your reward is great in heaven. For in the same way, they persecuted the prophets who were before you." The Gospel of Christ. For all the saints who from their labors rest, who thee by faith before the world confessed, thy name, O Jesus, be forever blessed. Hallelujah. O may thy soldiers, faithful, true, and bold, fight as the saints who nobly fought of old, and win with them the victor's crown of gold. Hallelujah. I speak to you in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, Son of God, and in the fellowship of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Beloved of the Lord, saints of the church, good morning. It's a joy and privilege to be here in the Hub of Your Cure this morning. My task, my privilege today is to lead us in thanksgiving to God for having the greatest occupation in life. Believe it or not, one of the greatest occupations in this life is to be a saint of the church. To appreciate the high esteem in which this occupation is held, you have to know the importance of the church. And the best explanation of the importance of the church is found in Matthew chapter 16, verses 17 and 18, which has Jesus saying to the spiritual insight that Simon Peter had received the following words, and I quote, "And I tell you, you are Peter, and on this rock I will build my church, and the gates of hell will not prevail against it." End of quote. From this conversation that Jesus has with Peter, we glean that the church is an organization and an organism that has as its task to be eternal, to be authentic, to be ever relevant, to be something that can never be defeated, not here on earth, and certainly not in heaven. I pause to ask us this question. It really is a rhetorical question. And it goes like this. How many of us would like to be part of such an organization and an organism? That is, one that is eternal, always relevant, can never be defeated. I trust that all of us have the desire, because the church, imperfect as it is still the means by which God is demonstrating to the world what the kingdom of God is like. And this is why, in the Lord's Prayer, that prayer that Jesus modeled for his disciples as to how we should pray, that is, converse with God, there is the line in the prayer that says, "Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven." This begs the question of what is the kingdom of heaven concerned about? Every Anglican Christian should know the answer, because it is at the heart of the liturgy of the Eucharist that we do each Sunday. It says on page 125 in the Book of Common Prayer, and I quote, "The kingdom of God is justice, peace, and joy inspired by the Holy Spirit. They who thus serve Christ are acceptable to God and approved by others." Let us put it another way, the way of 1 Corinthians 12:13 and Romans 14 verse 19. Those verses state, and I quote, "We are the body of Christ. By the one Spirit we were all baptized into one body and have all been made to drink of the one Spirit. Let us then pursue the things that make for peace and build up the common life." End of quote. Again, this is located in our Book of Common Prayer, page 124 through to 125. Our occupation as saints of the church is therefore to be workers of an organization and organism that embodies what it means to build community and delight in spirituality. It sounds easy, doesn't it? When we say it on a Sunday morning, it sounds like something that everyone should desire. However, the reality of this carnal world is that persons find satisfaction and salvation in things materialistic and by being individualistic. Therefore, anytime Jesus and his disciples in every generation attempt to transform the world more into what the kingdom of God is like, there comes a great pushback from outside of the church against these efforts. We must note on this day, however, that sometimes the pushback comes from within the church as well. It is sad to say, but it is true. It was true in the times of the Bible, as the following excerpts from today's reading will support. The first excerpt is from the Book of Revelation, chapter 7, verses 9, 13, and 18. It says, and I quote, "After this, I looked, and there was a great multitude that no one could count from every nation, from all tribes and peoples and languages, standing before the throne and before the Lamb, robed in white with palm branches in their hands. Then one of the elders addressed me, saying, "Who are these robed in white, and where have they come from?" I said to him, "Sir, you are the one that knows." Then he said to me, "These are they who have come out of the great ordeal. They have washed their robes and made them white in the blood of the Lamb." End of quote. From this excerpt from Revelation chapter 7, notice two things. Number one, saints have an intimate relationship with Christ that allows them to persevere in spite of the ordeal. And next, number two, saints are a diverse set of persons. Now, the other excerpt that I would like to share is from the gospel reading for today, Matthew chapter 5, verse 10 and verse 12. It says, and I quote, "Blessed are those who are persecuted for righteousness' sake, and blessed are you when people revile you and persecute you and utter all kinds of evil against you falsely on my account." That is, because of Jesus and the way of the cross. "Rejoice and be glad, for your reward is great in heaven. For in the same way they persecuted the prophets who were before you." End of quote. Again, note the connection that one must have with Jesus if you are to be part of the disciples that have responsibility for promoting the kingdom of God. Yes, this is a privilege that we have when we are saints. We have confidence of our relationship with Christ Jesus. Christ Jesus is in us and we are in him, as the second reading for today suggests. However, with this great privilege, one must expect a great pushback, especially when the world has become very materialistic and individualistic as it has become today. This pushback may be very harsh, very costly, and even very deadly. Yet we accept it because we know that Christ has already conquered sin, death, and evil. And so, as the Apostle Paul states in his letter to the Romans, we can press on because, as is written in Romans 8 verse 31, if God is for us, who can be against us? And as is written in Romans 8:38-39, we are sure that neither life nor death nor anything else in all creation will be able to separate us from the love of God in Christ Jesus. So, brothers and sisters, on this All Saints' Day, one of the primary feasts of the church, with that knowledge that we have been talking about so far, we can press on with the task of maturing as saints and recruiting new saints for the present age and especially for the future. However, I must remind us of what I said earlier. Sometimes the pushback against the characteristics of the kingdom of God and the way of the cross comes also from within the church herself. And here I get a bit controversial as I ask us to reflect on the fact that although as an organization and an organism, we may all subscribe to the same principles, we do not always subscribe to the same policies for implementation of the principles. This is where, as saints, we can agree on principles surrounding abortion, human sexuality, poverty, and wealth, but we may differ on the policies for implementation. When that happens, when these disagreements arise, do we crucify the one who disagrees with us? Do we go ahead with unjust and immoral policies simply to achieve a principle? These are hard questions that we must reflect on as the saints of the church in the 21st century. There are no easy answers. And to further complicate matters, even within each of us as individuals, there is a pushback going on inside of us against the characteristics of the kingdom of God and the way of the cross, as our spiritual side battles with our carnal side. Again, there are no easy answers. But this sermon shall not end in despair, but hope. And that hope is in God, as reflected in the crucified Christ and the cross. And it is to him and his way of living that we turn for answers to the hard questions of life. And it is through Christ, through him, that we issue the invitation to others, especially the youth, to be saints of the church. Therefore, All Saints Day, like any feast day, is ultimately a call to a relationship with Christ Jesus and a constant prayer for wisdom to discern by the power of the Holy Spirit what comes closest to the way of the cross in any given situation. It is when we prayerfully engage this task of sainthood that these words in our Book of Common Prayer, which we say Sunday after Sunday, come alive and meaningful for us. I give us two examples. Page 112 in the Book of Common Prayer. I quote, "We commend all people to your unfailing love, that in them your will may be fulfilled. And we rejoice at the faithful witness of your saints in every age, praying that we may share with them in your eternal kingdom." And then on page 110, "For ourselves and all who confess the name of Christ, that we may show forth the excellencies of him who called us out of darkness into his marvelous light." We would note that these petitions occur at the end of the prayers of the people. It's the sort of climax to the prayers, making the point that what we have prayed for demands our willingness and availability, collaborating with God through Jesus Christ by the power of the Holy Spirit to make what we have prayed for a reality to the best of our ability. And therefore it emphasizes the point that to be a saint and sainthood is a task of making the kingdom of God come on earth as it is in heaven by going the way of the cross. And that's what we celebrate today, that we are recommitting ourselves to this task, giving thanks for those who did so in times past and have now passed on the baton to us. And whilst we are running this leg of the relay, note that it is our task to recruit others to run alongside us and to succeed us in this ever constant task of making sure the church is eternal, the church is authentic, the church is relevant, that the church can stand against the gates of hell. Not in its own strength, of course, but by the grace of Jesus Christ, who has already won for us the victory by his death and resurrection. And so with that thought, let me end how I began, with another set of words from that famous All Saints Day hymn, number 819. And this time, I quote these verses. "O blessed communion, fellowship divine, we feebly struggle, they in glory shine. Yet all are one in thee, for all are thine." Hallelujah. "And when the strife is fierce, the warfare long, steals on the air the distant triumph song, and hearts are brave again and arms are strong. Hallelujah. Oh, when the saints go marching in, oh, when the saints go marching in, oh Lord, I want to be in that number when the saints go marching in. In the name of God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, amen.
As we reflect on the words of Canon Michael Allen, we will sing the hymn, When the Saints Go Marching In. We will now stand and affirm our Christian faith in the words of the Apostles' Creed, found on page 42 in our Book of Common Prayer. Together, I believe in God, the Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, His only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again, he ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. As our Savior has taught us, so we are bold to pray.
Our Father who art in heaven, holy, holy, holy be thy name. Our Father who art in heaven, holy be
service continues this morning with our intercessor prayer for All Saints Day. During the prayers, your response will be, after hearing Lord in your mercy, hear our prayer. United in the company of all the faithful, with our minds fixed on spreading the gospel and looking for the coming of the kingdom, let us offer our prayers to God, the source of all life and holiness. Let us remember those who have gone on before us. May your church, built on the foundation of the saints, be faithful to the teaching of Christ so that it reflects his likeness. Lord, as you enkindle the flame of your love in the hearts of the saints, grant to our minds the same faith and power of love, that as we rejoice in their triumphs, we may profit by their examples. Lord, in your mercy. God, Heavenly Father, we thank you today for calling us your saints. In spite of our unholy lives, you look at us and see your perfect life and death covering us. Thank you for this grace, the grace you received when we were baptized. Lord, in your mercy. Thank you for everyone who has helped us on our journey and encouraged us to keep believing when we felt like giving up. Thank you for all those who taught us the faith. Thank you for those who made the ultimate sacrifice of their lives to ensure others could hear of your love in Christ. Lord, in your mercy. Today, we remember those who have gone on before us. We remember our saints and all souls. Thank you for releasing them from the burden of sin and death in this life and for keeping your promise to them. We remember those from our community and church in our cure today, the cure of St. Boniface, which consists of St. Boniface in Harborview, St. Peter's in Port Royal, and St. Martin's in Bull Bay. Give comfort to all of us who grieve over loved ones no longer with us on earth. Give us the hope and peace only your words can offer. Keep alive in us their memory, and grant that every remembrance which turns our hearts from things seen to things unseen may lead us upward to you until we come to our eternal rest. Lord, in your mercy, we pray for your church on earth, that it may remain faithful to the apostles' teaching and that it will strive for unity. We pray for all who have recognized and turned to you, especially those under persecution, that they may imitate the martyrs in bold witness to the gospel. We also pray for those who are not yet part of your church, and for those who have left it, asking your Spirit to convince them of your love, that love which you have for them in Jesus Christ. Lord, in your mercy, bring peace to those nations in conflict and where there is political instability. Protect those who are poor and hungry and give them hope. Move those with plenty to share with those who have little. Help all people to love their neighbor as themselves. Lord, in your mercy. God of fellowship, we pray for our families and friends, that you will be to them all that they most deeply need. We thank you for the fellowship of your people here. May we, as a family of your people, be rooted and established in your love and faith, and come to know the extent of your grace as you dwell in us. Lord, in your mercy. God of healing, we bring to you those whose lives are darkened by pain, fear, weariness, or have been affected in any way. Come to our aid, Lord Jesus. Help us to bear what must be carried, and take from us all resentment and bitterness, replacing it with the abundance of your peace. At this time, Lord, we remember the elderly, the housebound, the homeless, and the lonely. And we pray for all those who selflessly minister to the needs of them and others. Lord, in your mercy, and now, Lord, we pray for our own needs and intentions, which we now recall in our hearts. Lord, in your mercy, let us pray. Collect for today, the 22nd Sunday of Pentecost, proper 26, also known as All Saints Day. Almighty God, you have knit together your elect in one communion and fellowship in the mystical body of your Son, Christ our Lord. Give us grace so to follow your blessed saints in all virtuous and godly living, that we may come to those ineffable joys that you have prepared for those who truly love you. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, who with you and the Holy Spirit lives and reigns, one God in glory everlasting. Amen. We now have a prayer for our gifts.
Let us pray. Faithful Father, thank you that you give the gift of abundant eternal life. You have said that you are a good Father who gives us good gifts. Your generosity overflows to us. Everything we have is a gift from you. As we bring our offerings to you, we give back to you from the abundant blessings you have given us. May our gifts be accepted in your sight. O Lord our God, blessing and glory, wisdom and thanksgiving, honor and power and strength be unto you, our God, forever and ever. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen.
Together into your hands. Into your hands we commend ourselves this day. Let your presence be with us to its close. Strengthen us to remember that in whatever good work we do, we are serving you. Give us a diligent and watchful spirit, that we may seek in everything to know your will, and knowing it, may gladly perform it to the honor and glory of your name. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. O God, you make us glad with the weekly remembrance of the glorious resurrection of your Son, O Lord. Give us this day such blessing through our worship of you, and that the week to come may be spent in your favor. Through Jesus Christ, O Lord. Amen. Prayer of Dedication and page 47. Together. Almighty God, we thank you for the gift of your holy word. May it be a lantern to our feet, a light to our paths, and a strength to our lives. Take us and use us to love and serve all persons in the power of the Holy Spirit and in the name of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen.
The Spirit of truth lead you into all truth. Give you grace to confess that Jesus Christ is Lord and to proclaim the word and works of God. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be among you and remain with you always. Amen.
Good morning, brothers and sisters in Christ. I want to extend a warm and vivacious welcome to you, and I trust that you have been indeed blessed. Thank you for joining or tuning in Sunday morning after Sunday morning on YouTube to hear the Word of God, showing your steadfast love and dedicated not to us but to the Word of God and to the fellowship with all your saints. We have a few notices. First, please help our youngsters to log into the Diocesan YouTube channel for weekly online Sunday school. It's an interesting and upbeat learning experience for them. You're being reminded as well to tune in to Radio Jamaica 94 FM every Sunday at 4:45 p.m. for our Diocesan program, Think on These Things. Also, for those persons who can't access social media, the delayed broadcast of this morning's service at the St. Andrew Parish Church may be heard on Love 101 FM this evening at 6 p.m. Our Archbishop, the Most Reverend Dr. Howard Gregory, is the celebrant and preacher. Friends, we need to collect your donation towards the purse for the retired Bishop of Kingston, the Right Reverend Dr. Robert Thompson, today. A special service of recognition is planned for this Sunday, for Sunday, November 15, at 11:30 a.m. It will be streamed live via Zoom, and we will be provided with the link as soon as it is available. The series Conversations Around the Diocese continues this Wednesday, November 4 at 6 p.m. Join the discussion on Facebook and YouTube via WATC.876. The topic is, Are We the Church Jesus Intended? The speakers are the Reverend Dr. Garnet Roper of the Missionary Church Association of Jamaica, Dr. Eleanor Henry of St. Jude's Church, Stonyhill, and Reverend Canon Michael Allen, Rector of the Church of the Ascension, Mona Heights. We now look to our birthdays and anniversaries for this week, November 1 to 7. We want to express our heartiest congratulations to Owen and Melissa Dillon, who celebrate their 19th wedding anniversary this November 3. We pray and ask God's continued blessing on their life, on their union, and that they will live to see many, many, many more years. For birthdays this week,
thank you.
those celebrating birthday no cure, this week we pray and ask God's richest blessing on you, and that you will live to see not just one more year, but many years to come. You let us remember the sick, the shut-in, the elderly members and friends in our cure. Let us remember those in nursing homes or those who are hospitalized, who we have not seen since the COVID-19 outbreak. Please give them a call. Let them know they are still valued members of our church family and community. So, as we go through this week, let us remember them in our prayers and call where we're able to. Thank you to the Reverend Canon Michael Allen for his thought-provoking message this morning, reminding us about the whole idea of sainthood. We want to thank our technical team as well, and members who contributed to this morning's presentation, and everyone who joined us in the virtual space. I hope this service was a blessing to you, and I invite you to join us again next Sunday at 10 a.m. As you go through the rest of the day and week, I just want to leave a few words with you from Father Michael Allen's sermon this morning. And it says, "Let us press on building the kingdom of God through sainthood, paving the way for others to follow." So as you go through the rest of today and this week, let us remember these words. Let us press on building the kingdom of God through sainthood, paving the way for others to follow. I do wish for you and your family, near and far, a productive, restful rest of the day and a God-guided week. Thank you all. Thank you. Our closing hymn, number 750 from our CPWI, "Tell out my soul the greatness of the Lord." It will be sung to the tune 325, "Go Forth and Tell." May the God of hope fill us with all joy and peace in believing through the power of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The Lord be with you. Let us bless the Lord.